Hi everyone, we're in San Diego, California at the Kona Kai Marina, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 1998 Navigator 5300 Classic. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this magnificent yacht has.
So here we are looking at the 98 Navigator 5300 Classic. And as we can see here up at the bow, we have a really nice bow pulpit here that is fully encompassed with the stainless steel lifelines leading to an electric windlass. Working our way down the side of the vessel, there are two chairs in front of a deck-mounted life raft. We do have a windscreen up forward to kind of protect the interior, and large windows. Also, as you're gonna notice, all of the canvas has been recently replaced, and it is absolutely beautiful. It's out of the macrolon material, and they've done a really nice job. All right, so as we come to the back of the vessel, you can see the back is fully enclosed with the macrolon. There are opening windows as well. We have really nice basket weave, teak and holly look material here at the back of the vessel. We also have our shore power inlet with a Glendinning that allows us to electronically, retrieve and pull out the electrical cable here. Quite nice. We also have a swim step shower and a washdown at the back. All right, so as we come into the aft cockpit, you're gonna notice again, just a nice extension patio room out here. Down below, we have engine access. We also have secondary engine access from the galley as well. But as we come aboard, you're gonna see these large windows, doors that just open up, and it really brings us to a nice entryway into the salon of the vessel. Off to the starboard side of the salon is a large couch, a seating area, and then off to the port side, we have double chairs with our full entertainment system, flat screen television, stereo, direct TV, and the whole nine yards. Just forward of this is our galley. The galley is quite nice. Off to the starboard side, we have a little storage area with a wine cooler here. Double door refrigerator, freezer compartment here, and then a really nice galley. What I love about the galley is not only is there so much usable countertop space, but it integrates the three burner stovetop. We have shelving behind these smoked kind of glass doors, air conditioning, heating controls here, and our Panasonic convection oven as well. Double stainless steel sinks with garbage disposal, overhead storage, and just tons of storage here in the galley. Underneath this mat is the second engine room storage access. There's a huge storage room underneath this area, and then through a door you go into the engine room itself. The other really nice feature I love about the 5300 Classic is just the openness that you have from your upper dinette area into the galley and salon. So it feels like you're all connected when on board. Here we have the electrical panel system. Here you're gonna see all of our DC, AC, and transfer switches. Again, this is a nicely set up electrical panel, and it's really nice and convenient on its location. All right, as we move up forward, here's a nice look of the flying dinette. So it's up a little bit higher. Again, you have that really nice visibility, so you stay, in connection with all of your guests on board. But this is a nice U-shaped seating area around the dinette table. The side windows open. And then we have our lower helm station. Here at the lower helm station, we have our engine controls. We have our throttle controls here. We also have our Westmar bow thruster control to starboard and port. We have two navigation systems on this vessel. We have a Raymarine navigation system, and then we have a separate independent SIMRAD as well that's up at top. And both have integrated radars in them as well too. Large compass here and VHF. I want to take you for a quick tour to the bow of the vessel. So as we come out on the starboard side, you can see again the life raft, this large foredeck area that will just really house a lot of people. You can put chairs, cushions up here if you so desire, but really impressive square footage. Just above this eyebrow, we have our spotlight. And then up above on that stainless steel post on top of the arch, we have our Raymarine radar, SIMRAD radar, and track vision. We also have large VHF antennas out on the side. All right, coming back in, we're gonna go down below, and first we're going to come down a couple steps, and then we have a hanging locker storage off to the starboard side. As we move down here, this will give us access to our three cabins, two heads. We have the master cabin aft, which is centership here. And this is a beautiful master cabin, lots of headroom, a large queen size berth here. Behind these two doors, we have a washer, a dryer, and then look at all of this storage area right here. So this is all cedar inlaid storage area. We have a flat screen television here with DirecTV. And your Apple TV connected to that as well. Your own separate private head shower compartment. Here you can see we have the sink, our vanity, additional shelving. I like how they've mirrored the ceiling. It really kind of gives it a nice open feel, so it makes the space feel much, much larger than it is. And a full walk-in shower with great headroom as well. So really nice addition here to a master cabin. All right, as we move up forward, we are gonna go off to the port side. The port has double bunk beds. This is a great area for kids, and or you can use this as additional storage if so desired. There are two lockers here for storage. Directly across it is our guest head and shower compartment. Here we have a separate shower and then a nice vanity, mirrors. Again, they've kind of done the mirror above the ceiling. And then we have vacuum flush toilets that are fresh water. So a very respectable guest cabin, guest head. And up here is our VIP cabin. The VIP cabin also has a queen centerline berth. It is up higher, as you can see, with storage down below it. A full hanging locker behind this mirrored door. And then again, great accessibility. You have opening ports as well too, but a very large cabin. Overhead opening hatch as well. And then this will bring us coming back aft. We're gonna go up the flight of stairs, up to the flybridge. So as we make our way up to the flybridge, again, what I wanna point out is this really neat basket weave floor that they've installed. We have the starboard single helm seat here. We also have large seating all around this aft area. So it's quite, a great area to be out here. It's good for entertaining, phenomenal visibility. And then we also have our Brower Systems dinghy lift. And this is the base here for a dinghy. So that really houses that quite nicely when underway. As we move up to the forward helm, you're gonna notice a nice double bench seat here. Here we have our second Raymarine E80 chart plotter display. Again, it has its own isolated radar, VHF. We have transmission controls, bow thruster controls, engine controls for both port, starboard. We also have the newer Simrad GPS plotter, Tri-Data, and Robertson autopilot. So this is set up quite nicely. Not to mention this phenomenal view that you see here. And this is a potential transferable slip. Well, this concludes the video walkthrough for the Navigator 5300 Classic. If you would like more information in regards to this yacht, please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.